Hello, and welcome to a new coding adventure. Today we're going to be looking at marching cubes. I'm afraid that's what passes for humor on this channel. Now, before I can get to the actual marching cubes, we'll need some function that takes in a point in 3D space and gives out a single value. Then, if we have some region of space that we're particularly interested in, we could use that function to sample points at regular intervals inside of it. The highest value I got with my particular function was 16, which I've colored white, and the lowest was negative 34, which I've colored black. Now, I'm going to add a little slider here called the surface level. As I move it up, you can see that the points with values below the surface level will disappear. So those points we can think of as being in empty space, while the points at or above the surface level are on the surface or inside of some shape. The goal of the marching cubes algorithm is to construct the surface of that shape from triangles so that we can display it as a mesh. To think about how this works, we can simplify the problem to just a single cube. There are 8 corner points, each of which can be the inside or outside of the shape, which gives us 2 to the power 8, or 256 different configurations. For example, with just one point inside the shape, we get a single triangle over here. If the point above it is also inside the shape, we get a little rectangle made from 2 triangles, and so on. As you can see, some of the configurations get pretty wild, but thankfully there are only 14 unique cases, the rest are just symmetries of those. But still, figuring this out is a tremendous headache that I did not want to undertake, so I took the easy way out and downloaded a triangulation table like this from the internet. So let's take this case for example. Corner points 7, 5, and 1 are active, which we can interpret as configuration 10100010, or in a more familiar number system, configuration 162. This is the code for calculating that index, just in case you're interested. Now, I can take this index and look up the corresponding entry in that triangulation table. This tells me to join edges 501 and 540 and 7611 to form 3 triangles. So in code, I look up the triangulation info here and loop through each edge index. I then look up, in another little table, the indices of the 2 corner points that form that edge. With those, I can calculate the position at the center of the edge and add that to my list of vertices. All we need to do now is march through the entire space and construct the mesh one cube at a time. Behold, marching cubes. By the way, in the code I just showed, I was creating a new vertex regardless of whether one already existed in that position. A more sophisticated implementation could share vertices between triangles, but I just wanted to make it as simple as possible for the example. The result here is also extra blocky looking because I'm always placing vertices at the midpoint of the edge, but to be more accurate, we should try estimate where along the edge the surface actually is. For example, if the value at the bottom of an edge is negative 2 and at the top it's 3, and the surface value was say 0, we would estimate that the surface is 40% up from the bottom of the edge, since that's where 0 would be if the value was changing linearly. Alright, so once I'd kind of wrapped my head around these ideas and convinced my triangles to behave themselves, I started experimenting with a little terrain editor. This works simply by adding or subtracting from the points under the brush. It's a little slow and finicky at the moment, but still kind of cool to play around with, so I'd definitely like to improve it at some point. I then began experimenting with layering noise in increasing frequencies and decreasing amplitudes to generate terrain. I didn't spend too long on this, but I think in general the results are more interesting looking than pure height map terrain, because you get some overhangs and nice details like that, although sometimes the physical feasibility is questionable. Anyway, one effect that I found kind of cool is terracing. So the value at each point in space is being calculated as negative position.y, which creates a ground plane, plus the noise value at that position. To add terraces, we just need to add position.y mod the terrace height that we want. A small change to the calculation, and we have spherical worlds instead. While I was playing with some more noise, I created something that looked a little like a fish tank, and I thought it might be fun to explore an infinite underwater world. To support an endless world, I needed to be able to break things up into chunks, like so. Once I had that working, I added a little cylinder as a submarine so I could swim around, and I also converted my marching cube script to a compute shader, which sped it up a lot. This would be great if it didn't also turn everything into spaghetti. The problem was that I was adding vertices one at a time, and because this is multi-threaded, vertices from other threads were getting added in between, messing up the order of the triangles. I've only recently started learning about compute shaders, 2 episodes ago to be precise, so I'm not sure what the correct way to tackle this is, but my crude fix was to create a triangle struct, assign 3 vertices to that, and then append that to the buffer. Finally, I upgraded the submarine from a cylinder to a capsule, plus some tiny bits, and I was away. I'd definitely like to expand on the terraforming tool, and experimenting with the erosion from the first episode on the terrain from this episode would be pretty interesting as well, I think. Anyway, until next time, cheers!